you have some segment and you want, and you have a phone, you speak by phone or by Skype or by some. You cannot send a letter, you just speak by phone. And you want your friend in another city to construct the segment exactly the same. How can you do this? So how can you explain that you want a segment of this size? So if you have the same, if you have, both of you have the same ruler with the same centimeters, then you get the correct. But it's really a problem. If in another town you don't have the same rulers, for example, like in the United States, they have different. Everything measured in inches. So I don't know. Probably there is no way how to, you can imagine. You speak with your friend in the United States. He sees the ruler with inches, and you see the ruler with centimeters. How can you find what is the relation between inches and centimeters? Who is bigger? So probably there is no way to do this except for if you just can send something by post while speaking. It's difficult. So who invented, by the way, you know, maybe who invented the 1 meter? How it was? Why people decided that 1 meter is exactly like this? Do you know some history? How the idea of meter was invented? When it was invented, for example? In Euclid elements in Greece, when they wrote the textbook, do they know what is 1 meter or not?
No.
And when of course they have some other units, they measured something, but just the exactly 1 meter, when it was defined?
Yes, that's all.
Я знаю,
это
большое картин. Wait, yeah.
Идет
18th century. And when it was?
French Revolution.
So French Revolution, they, yeah. Okay, so there are different stories. So first French Revolution decided that, and usually for revolutions, they decided that everything should be changed. The world is now different. Nothing can be used. So they changed the names of the month, I don't know, the weekdays, they changed it or not. The Monday, Tuesday, probably not, I don't know why. But at least the month, they are completely different names. And they changed all the units. So they decided they will invent a new unit, 1 meter. And they wanted to define it in some special way. So what is this way? What is 1 meter according to French Revolution?
Измеряли они меридиан, но они знали, сколько там градусов. У них была хорошая астрономия, они, разумеется, измеряли часть меридиана. Ну, при их точности это было неважно.
Okay, so they decided that the Earth should be exactly even the sphere, actually it's not a sphere, but let's forget about this. It should be 40,000 kilometers. So it should be 40 millions of meters. It's not, they have this idea and they have tried to make some measurement to find this, but they made some special metal bar of this size. And it was made of special metal, which do not react to temperature, because usually they grow and shrink. But they made an etalon of 1 meter, for a long time it was just a definition. So indeed they needed some definition. But now the question is that they have an etalon of 1 meter, but also they did not make an etalon of 1 degree. So why they made an etalon of a meter but not an etalon of a degree? Okay, what do you think?
Because 1 degree is
360th part of the circle. Yeah, because for degrees we have a natural kind of natural etalon. It's the entire circle. The entire circle is by definition 360 degrees. So the only problem is that we need to cut it into very accurately in equal part and to be sure that it's exactly 360. So if we have the most practical way is imagine you have a paper. So how you make an etalon of something? First you need to make a line. So you can use the end of the paper, but usually they are not maybe of bad quality. So imagine you have, I don't want to imagine you have a piece of paper with bad borders. How you make an etalon of a line? What is the simplest way? Do you get it? Yeah. So what do you do? Oh, you just cut it into, it's better to cut it into two, so you get to get a bigger line. So we just cut a paper and get a very nice line. And so this line is an etalon of 180 degrees. And if you want to have 90 degrees, what do we do? Make something. Okay, you divide it into halves. And you just need to make very, very accurate this thing. And why the angle? Because you see, this is an angle. This is an angle. And this is an angle. And why the angle? Because if we put the paper like this, they exactly match. So we get two equal angles. And so we have an etalon of 90 degrees. And how, if we want to have 45 degrees, what do we do? Okay, so how you get 45 degrees? Of course, you just cut it into pieces. And so... No, it's more difficult. For this you need probably a compass. But, so this is, for angles you don't need some French Revolution, you don't need the etalons, you just make a sheet of paper and cut everything and whatever. Okay, so this is about measurement of angles and